Y'all, thank you. Thank you for being here. I hope you were upstairs. We had a nice press conference up there with good information. These are just some of the, to bring everyone up to date on how we're doing in South Carolina. We're doing extremely well. We are making progress. On telephone a conference yesterday with General Perna, whom I've mentioned to you before, who's in charge of the distribution effort, the vaccine effort, as well as some new people who are on the team there that for these conferences that we've been having over the months since the virus arrived. We were informed that those manufacturers, Pfizer and Moderna, well, originally, as we knew, and I think I've told you all, they were making about 8.6 million doses a week. Well, they in the ensuing weeks, they have revved up. They're doing more. So now they're up to about 10 million doses a week. And what that means is we will get about 16% more, our fair share, coming into South Carolina starting next week. And we've also been assured by General Perna, Gus Perna, that, as I mentioned before, sometime in March, we expect to see more. It's gradually coming up, but also there'll be other manufacturers coming online, Janssen and Johnson & Johnson. But in order, our job is to get that vaccine out and get it into the arms. And last week, we urged and pushed the hospitals to work harder to assign more people to speed up the vaccination process, and they have done so. Some of them have actually given more than 100% of the allocated doses, because sometimes you can get 6 or maybe 7 shots out of a 5-dose vial. So that's why you read that some of the hospitals are actually over 100%. But that was our main focus. They were already stood up. They're ready to go. They're in action. There were some slow starts in some places, but we urged them to speed it up, and they did. Also, we've made clear that the National Guard is available. The National Guard is involved in, I think, about 18 different locations around the state assisting. They've helped stand up some mass vaccine sites. Our National Guard contingent is back from Washington, and they will be available for things here in the state. Getting this vaccine in the arms is a priority. So I urge those locations that need help, the National Guard is available. Just have to let us know. Also, our action a week or so, 10 days maybe, where we authorize the retired doctors, nurses, medical students, and others to give vaccinations is working. They are calling DHEC, hundreds, and also many are going directly to the hospitals around the state and volunteering with them without going through DHEC. So that has worked as well and is helping us move the people through, get the lines, get the vaccines in the people's arms. As you know, a couple of weeks ago, we opened the vaccine up to those 70 and above. Everyone knows that it's the older population that is more at risk. And the CDC they're contemplating moving the eligibility to those 65 and older. We would like to do that here as well as soon as we can. We know that the average age of the people that are succumbing to the virus, that is passing away, is 75. So we have to get the vaccine out to every part of the state, to everyone who wants to take it, with the understanding always that it is the older, the senior population that is the most at risk and the most that are actually dying from the vaccine. We have a lot of locations in South Carolina that are open. You can go on the DHEC map, the website, and you see the green dots. More and more pharmacies are coming online. We have about 600 pharmacies that have registered their willingness to participate. The number is growing every day. We understand there may be as many as 455 that are giving the shots now, or right on the edge of giving the shots. That will help a lot. Those are the Moderna. That's the Moderna vaccine there. The Pfizer is in the hospitals. We are now ranked. There's been some interest in our ranking on how well we're doing, and there was some misleading as well as inaccurate figures. We are now 26 in the in the nation according to the Centers for Disease Control and the total number of shots given, 26. We're also about 26 in population. So we are doing very well, as well as the other states, and we hope to do better and better and to give a shot to everyone who wants one. CVS and Walgreens have completed their first pass through the long-term care facilities and the nursing homes. It's CVS and Walgreens that are our federal partners who are handling that part of the work with the Moderna vaccine. You may notice that there are some excess doses. It appears they've completed their first pass, we think, through all of them. And the total nursing homes and long-term care facilities, there are over 500 of those in the state. They've almost completed their first pass, almost just a few left, and then they'll start their second pass. There's some people, again, like the rest of our population, want to wait a minute and think about it, so the second pass should take care of that. Then they'll have one more pass, and then the doses that are left over, if they haven't all been used up in those areas, we will use those in the pharmacies as more and more come online. So we're making progress. We intend to transfer those unused CVS and Walgreens doses as soon as possible. We discussed that last night with General Perna and the team in Washington, and everyone is enthusiastic, and the governors all around the country were glad to hear that news. So that's what's happening in South Carolina. I want to assure everyone that we are determined to get that vaccine into their arms, to everyone who wants it, quickly, as soon as possible, with the least hassle possible, with the least bottlenecks. We know we got a lot of people who want it. We have some who are waiting that don't want it yet. There may be some that don't want it at all. But our intention is to get it into those arms as quickly as possible in the urban areas, in the rural areas. We are working diligently to be sure that there are pop-up sites, that there are mass vaccination sites, and that everybody who wants one will be able to get one. But we still have some that we have in our possession that is going into arms now, but we do not have enough for everybody that wants one right now. That's why we're stepping it down, going, we hope soon, to 65 and older. But if I am confident that the production lines are in place, and that from what they're telling us, particularly General Gus Perna, is in March, we should have a dramatic increase between now and then, perhaps the end of March, perhaps earlier, in the vaccine. So everybody get ready, but in the meantime, you got to be careful. Wear that mask, avoid crowds, watch out what you're touching, keep your distance, call the doctor if you get sick, look for a vaccination site if you're one that's eligible, and be very careful, and we'll make it.